normally Japan government invites the chief of the country, but this is the first exception that they have invited a chief minister of a state. So it's an honor for us, and I do believe that when 21st century is Asia century, so democratic forces in Asia must come to closer and will have to strengthen democratic systems. Japan and India sharing the same values. If Japan and India comes together, I'm sure that it will strengthen the democratic values, it will strengthen the human values, and of course Gujarat is a state, very vibrant, industrially developed state, and Japan is also looking for investment in the different countries. And by and large, since last 5-7 years, the experience with Gujarat, as far as Japan is concerned, is very good. Gujarat is happy, Japan is happy. So we must exploit that opportunity. And because of that reason, I am here in Japan.
I see. And I'm pretty amazed as well, because, I mean, for the past 7 years, Gujarat has had double-digit growth. And if you are the PM, how would you see this apply to the whole country?
I took charge in 2001 as a chief minister, and we have already completed one decade. In one decade, Gujarat growth is more than 11%. In this one decade, the agriculture growth is more than 10%. And even in service sector, equally we are good. So we have a very balanced development, balanced growth. And of course, nowadays, people in India are discussing about the Gujarat growth story. Not only that, the developing countries are also thinking that the Gujarat can be a very good model for them. So my duty is to take care of the Gujarat. People have given me a responsibility to serve the Gujarat, and as per, and we are in a democratic system. When the people of Gujarat expect something from me, I am bound to do that.
I see. Could you talk a little bit about the Gujarat model, which you mentioned just now, which I found pretty, pretty interesting, because it seems to be a cut above what other...
Gujarat is a policy-driven state. We don't run the government in the whims of an individual. We don't take any decision in a temporary or day-to-day basis. We always think in a long-term process. We are a policy-driven state. We try to come with the policy in black and white. So whomsoever want to work with Gujarat easily can take the decision that yes, here is the policy. Whether it is acceptable to him or not, he can easily take the decision. So this is a policy-driven state. Then we have a political stability. Since last so many years, we are there in power. And when we are politically stable, we are not politically stable, but we are consistent in our policy also. We are not changing our policy according to the environment. We are very, very consistent in our policy. And when you are consistent in your policy, it creates a confidence level among the industrial groups, business houses, even in the farmers, even in the students. The another thing is that Gujarat is a state very successfully implemented public-private partnership model. When public-private partnership model is there, then there is a value of ownership. Each and everyone feels that, yes, this is my state, this is my business, I am doing something to progress the Gujarat. I am a part of the progress. So this gives a feeling of proud. And these are the reasons that Gujarat has given so many things.
I see. So it's a mid and long-term horizon thinking, and it's a long-term, mid, a medium to long-term thinking and planning with the public and private partnership? And if you are Prime Minister, will that be a consistent policy from India? I mean, do you intend to transfer this policy?
Narendra Modi is a Chief Minister of Gujarat. 60 million people of Gujarat has given a responsibility as a Chief Minister. My focus is Gujarat. My aim is Gujarat. My duty is Gujarat. And it's my duty to fulfill the aspirations of the people who gave me the duty.
I see. And how do you respond to critics who say that you aren't suitable for PM, for Prime Ministership because of what happened in 2002, because of the riots then?
Number one, don't mix up the two questions into one question. Please segregate the two questions. I would like to give you the answer for the first question. What is about the critics? Criticism is a beauty of the democracy. We must respect. If there is no criticism, democracy cannot work. So I always appreciate criticism. And criticism is the essence of the democracy. Criticism only can purify our system. So I always honor, I respect all the critics. But we must understand what is the criticism and what is the allegation. We do not understand the difference between allegation and criticism. Allegation is a different thing. Criticism is most welcome, I always welcome. And in democracy, I want a vibrant media, a very critical media, and that will purify the whole system. So I love the criticism. So I don't have any problem with the criticism. As far as second part is concerned, I already told you that I am responsible for the Gujarat. People of Gujarat has given me a responsibility, and it's my duty to fulfill their aspirations.
So you say to the critics, please carry on.
How I can promote critics? I cannot sponsor critics. If the sponsor critics are there, then it's not a democracy. It should be very natural. But when criticism comes, I must honor. I must say it's a valuable suggestion.
I see. And to build on top of that, I mean, despite the best efforts, you are still viewed as anti-Muslim. How are you changing the image across Gujarat and across the country?
How can you come to this conclusion? Do you have any statement in my whole life I have ever said anything wrong against any religion, any religious book, any prophet, any God? Do you have any single sentence? How one can be anti? And I belong to the Hindu and I belong to India, the Bharat, where our great traditions are there. What is our philosophy? We never say that if you believe in my philosophy, then you will achieve your goal. What we say that, ekam sat vipraha bahudha vadanti. Truth is one, sages call it in a different way. So we don't believe. We believe in one God. People think that He is Allah, another thing is a Isu, one says it's a Rama, one says it's a Krishna. It is up to the believers. God is one. We don't say that Hindu's God is separate, Muslim God is separate, Christian God is separate. This is not our philosophy. We believe in a Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, whole world is family. This is in our DNA, this is in our genetic system. I belong to a culture which culture says the whole world is one family. How can we hate any community, even any person? It's impossible.
I see. And turning now to politics, what do you think the BJP has to do to be successful in 2014 elections because it hasn't been a very strong opposition party.
Nowadays, in 2012 December, we are going for a Gujarat election. So my priority is to win the Gujarat election. And I'm sure the people of Gujarat will elect our government again. And they will give us our responsibility. We will think about 2013 or 14 because it is very difficult to say that election will come in 2014 or in 2013 or in a 2012 end because our central government is in a, they are facing so many internal problems. So I do not know. So whether it will have to wait up to 14 or not.
But are you confident in becoming the BJP's Prime Minister?
I am confident that NDA will come into power. BJP led, NDA will come to the power. I'm sure.
Why?
Because the country remembers the rule of the NDA under the leadership of Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Inflation was controlled. The infrastructure was, the work was going very fast. In the when Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee was there, the per day we were constructing 11 kilometer roads. Today it has come down to 3 kilometer only. So people remember when the inflation was controlled. People remember. So the people think that yes, NDA government was very good government. So people would like to bring them again into the power.
And after the violence that has killed that one person in Maruti Suzuki plant, like what's your take on this?
Just now I spoke into the public meeting, just now in the JETRO meeting. Of course it should not happen anywhere in the world, not in India or in Haryana or in Gujarat. It's not an issue where it has happened. Anywhere it should not happen. So the human safety is it's a priority. And I do feel that those who have lost their life, we are concerned with them. But I'm sure that Haryana government is capable enough to handle this issue and they will handle it.
And like for going circling back to Gujarat and extrapolating that to India as a whole, do you think what do you think Gujarat has that India doesn't? Like you're mentioning medium to long term policies and all that, but why hasn't the rest of India caught on?
I do not follow. Will you please repeat it?
The Gujarat model, which you mentioned just now, is a pretty successful one, and I'm just wondering why hasn't the rest of India caught on to this?
I don't think so. You see, since 2002, if you go to each and every election, whether it is in Gujarat or outside Gujarat, whether it is a state government election or a federal government election, in every election, nowadays agenda is a development. In past, in India, in election, development was never agenda. And this is the greatest contribution of the Gujarat. And people have accepted all over India that nowadays, if you are going to win the election, you will have to perform. People are not interested in promise nowadays. People are interested in the performance. So this urge is a contribution of the Gujarat story.
Development was never on the agenda? I mean, how can that...
People were using... sometimes they were thinking about the leader, sometimes they were thinking about the party, sometimes they were thinking about the caste combination. This was going on in my country. But nowadays, whatever caste you have, whatever area you belong to, whatever family you belong to, first you'll have to perform. If you are not going to perform, people will not accept you.
I always thought that.
So it's a good thing.
I see, yeah? I see. And one final question, like if you become PM, like what will you bring to the table for India?
In politics, if and buts have no place.
Do you have any aspirations for
this is what I said, in politics ifs and buts have no place.
So you're aiming for the Prime Ministership?
What I said is if and buts have no space in politics. I already told you that I am committed to Gujarat, I am committed to the 60 million people of Gujarat. They have given me a responsibility. I have to fulfill that responsibility.